welcome back to Warlord Mechanics. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. In today's video, guys, we'll be working here on a BMW 3 Series, guys. Generation 2005-2013. And if you have an airbag light on and code 93C3, okay, let me show you quick. We'll be diagnosing quick and show you what could be that. We'll show you guys what could be the reason, how you can probably fix that, and stay with us for more videos. Now, in the meantime, we have more than 200 videos on this car, so please hit that subscribe button for more videos. And if you need help with anything, drop a comment below the video and we'll try to make a video for you. I have the ignition on here and check out, the airbag light is on. Okay, that's really annoying. On the screen it says check passenger restraint system as well. Now, let me get the computer here quick and we're going to scan the system, show you what causes that code and what could be a simple, really simple fix for that. Okay, now we'll be using Maxicom here, guys. Okay, that computer works on most cars, not just BMW. Okay, and we're going to select control unit, body, airbag system. We're going to read the codes and check out the very last code now. 93C3. Okay, this code right here, 93C3, it says seat occupancy detector, passenger side. So, as you know, the airbag system on modern vehicles is complicated, but not too complicated. Okay, that seat right here on the passenger side, it has a mat underneath it that tells the computer if the person sitting in the seat is heavy enough for the airbag to be activated in case of a wreck, of an accident. So, that mat, guys, sometimes will go bad because you sit on that seat all the time, in and out, in and out. So eventually it could break and we'll have the video how to test it on the channel. So please check it out. But we'll show you today what could be a simple fix for that, what to check and which wires to check first before you actually start taking things apart. So if we come to the passenger side here and we look under the seat, there is one yellow connector. That yellow connector is actually, okay, let me position it here now, is the one for the seat. So you need to open that connector. Okay, let me go this way so you can see. There is one black thing. Okay, you need to slide it out. Okay, perfect. Pull it out. Now, you have to check all the pins inside the passenger. That mat sensor for the weight will be part of the black clip. Okay, you can see that the big clip consists of three little ones. The black one is the main one. Two of the wires will be actually for that weight mat. Okay, occupancy mat. Always make sure everything's clean because spilled drinks, coffee and moisture will cause that. Sometimes if you live in a humid climate by the coast or you get a lot of snow or rain, you might have some oxidation or corrosion here, so you want to make sure everything's clean. Use electrical connector cleaner and reconnect it and see if that fixes the problem. The other thing to check is the connector. Okay, for that occupancy mat is all the way back there under the seat. Okay, I think it's a triple wire, and it comes out like brown, blue and white with red, I believe. So check that connection there to make sure it's not loose, because if somebody stuck their foot from the back under your front seat, they could have got the sensor loose. So check that connection there, check this connection, guys, and after that, okay, you can test the sensor to make sure that it performs good. Now, we'll have the video how to test the sensor on the channel, so please check it out. It won't be very complicated at all. So thank you for watching. Please subscribe, guys, and see you next time.